the founder of Pencil 9 and being an entrepreneur who is bringing women back to workforce. What was your inspiration behind this idea?
Honestly, it was just a seed when it started off, when, you know, I really did not think that Pencil 9 would go so big. I have seen gold medalists sitting at home because they're not allowed to go out and work. You know, I've seen university toppers, I've seen like really good people, some who are like very close friends of mine, who actually do not get the opportunity to go out and work. And then some, you know, who, yeah, so some who have like second innings, who really want to do it, you know, by after taking a break after marriage, post-marriage, they want to take a break for like 2 years, 3 years, you know, have their first baby and then come back to work. But then they're not able to because, you know, they're stuck with so many responsibilities that they do not get the opportunity to actually leave their child with somebody and then, you know, go back to work and then spend about 8 to 9 hours in the office and then come back. So that's again a hassle for them. So as I actually started meeting people, so I met lots of women like this. You know, there has to be a balance where we give them an opportunity to work and they're able to do it. At the same time, they're able to strike that perfect balance between their home life and their work life. I'm glad that it actually worked because I was very skeptical in the beginning. I really didn't know whether it would actually work or not. And I started off with just two friends of mine. I mean, I tried to convince them and I told them that, you know, why not just give it a try? I don't know if it's going to work or not. Yeah, I'm lucky enough, actually. I think it just worked out and then we are here.
This sounds like a really heartwarming story, Trishita. This sounds really lovely.
Yes, it's overwhelming for me too.
As you mentioned, you faced various challenges throughout your entrepreneurial venture. What are those challenges? Yes. Can you please walk us through that?
The major challenge was convincing women. Mm-hmm. That was like number one, because then, you know, you have to ensure that it actually gets into her head that, you know, she needs to have that identity for herself. You know, she is a mother, she's a daughter, she's a sister, she's a sister-in-law, she has lots of relationships, but then, you know, she needs to have her own identity, and that is very important. So convincing a woman to actually come back to her work-life schedule and, you know, making her understand that it is important to build a second identity or build an identity for herself. And then again, convincing her to become financially independent. I cannot stress enough on it, but it is difficult. And then the second one was, so if she gets convinced, her family is not convinced. Since this is a work from home, she obviously needs a laptop. She obviously needs an internet connection. And stuff like that. And that becomes an additional burden to the husband. I have writers who actually work with me, but they're able to work only when their husband is done with his work. And then, you know, corona pandemic that we are in right now. So the kids are having online classes, the husbands are at home. So the laptop is not free. So they don't have any options to work. So again, that is a challenge. So it's like a cycle, you know. I have to convince the girl, I have to convince her family, and then, you know, again, you know, help them understand to make a schedule for themselves that, you know, they can work like 2 hours in the morning or 2 hours in the evening and they can still do it.
So you provide them with an opportunity of employment as well as counseling to get into the workforce again.
I cannot go without it. It just cannot go without it.
So Trishita, you have a team of 3,700 and more writers and creative people who all work remotely, presumably in different parts of the country. So how do you manage that vast team?
I have designated teams. The teams are decided. The teams are, you know, they all know their jobs well. So it's just communication, you know, just communicating with everybody and getting things done.
What do you think are the pros and cons of having a good team and having a team where there are communication barriers?
The only barrier that you can have in a team to make it to, you know, define between a good team and a bad team. If you have communication, then it's just anything can be just sorted out, whether it's a problem you know, you have an issue while working, you need to fix something, it can be done. But yeah, where there is a communication gap, you know, you end up into troubles, you do not meet deadlines. Communication is very important. And good thing is that now, you know, we are technically very sound. We are all socially well, you know, connected. We live in a very well connected world right now. So even if you are, like I said, even if you are in Langkawi Islands, you cannot say that you're not connected and, you know, I'm unable to reach you and stuff.
So do you think that women are conditioned into servitude of being housebound? That there are certain responsibilities that only shackle a woman and never shackle anybody else? So how can women get out of that servitude?
I would say a woman cannot get out of it unless it gets into the head of the male counterpart. Mm-hmm. It is definitely not possible. So telling a woman that, you know, you have responsibilities, you need to do certain things. So basically, you know, a woman certain, I have seen, you know, situations where a woman is defined only by being a homemaker, you know, her only job is to cook. A woman cannot come out of it so easily because, see, when you get married and when you get into a family, and that family has this particular thought in their mind, how can a woman come out of it? She cannot, because she wants to be in that marriage. She wants to, you know, take care of her kids. She wants to have that family. She cannot just leave that and come out of it. All that I can say is, you know, I want to talk to the men. I want to tell them, the uncles, the fathers, the father-in-laws, the brother-in-laws, all of these people, you know, so it is these people who need to understand that, you know, sharing responsibilities, sharing workload at home is very, very important. Mm-hmm. You got to start teaching your own brother that, you know, start doing things at home, start taking, you know, take workload, share your sister's workload. You know, it needs to start from your house, and then, you know, it can move out. It can just move ahead.
No, that this is perfect. This is what we want people to talk about these days.
It's my pleasure. I mean, I'm just telling you, like I said in, you know, just a couple of minutes ago, that I have writers who haven't been able to work during this, you know, during the lockdown, just because their husbands and their kids are at home and they're not given that opportunity to work. Because, you know, there are demands that she needs to fulfill. You know, aaj evening mein snacks banana hai, chai ke saath snacks chahiye because my husband is at home. The dinner has to be really nice because the kids are like getting bored having the same ghar ka khana. They're not getting outside food. So I need to cook up something really good so that, you know, I can keep them, you know, at home. There's no option for her to go without it. She has to do it because she needs to keep her kids engaged. She needs to keep her husband happy. Otherwise, again, you know, there are again issues like domestic violence. I'm sure you must have also heard. It's just increased during this time. It's like really bad. So the abuses are really bad. The domestic violence, the number of cases are really bad. So it's there. So whether you say it or you don't say it, it's reality.
Yeah.
All I'm trying to do is trying to find practical solutions to certain problems. And hopefully trying to sail through this.
Yeah. And I hope that you find more practical solution and bring more women to workforce, because we need organizations like Pencil 9 and we need entrepreneurs like you to bridge that gender gap that society is looking an increase at right now.